Hi everyone, in this video I am going to explain you about bryophyta classes Anthoceratopsida are hornworts and Bryopsida are mosses. Anthoceratopsida are hornworts. The plant body of this group is also thallus-like. Scales are absent but rhizoids are present on thallus. Rhizoids are unicellular and unbranched. Sporophyte of hornworts is divided into foot and capsule. The sporophyte of hornworts is not completely dependent on its gametophyte, which means it is partially dependent because its sporophyte is photosynthetic, therefore it can manufacture its own food. So it does not depend on gametophyte for food, it depends only for water and habitat. In hornworts, at the basal part of capsule, a special type of meristem is present. Due to the activeness of this meristem, the capsule grows rapidly. It grows like the horn of animals. Hence, these are called hornworts. Examples: Notothylus, Anthoceras. Note: Pseudoelaters are present in hornworts, which helps in spores dispersal. In hornworts, the basal part of capsule, a special type of meristem is present. Due to the activeness of this meristem, the capsule grows rapidly. It grows like horn of animals, so these are called hornworts. Example: Notothylus and Anthoceras. Because of presence of pseudoelaters in capsule, they helps in dispersal of spores. The next class of bryophyta is Bryopsida or mosses. All the mosses are included in this class. The plant body of mosses is made up of stem-like, leaf-like and rhizoids, root-like. The rhizoids present in the plants of this class are multicellular, branched and obliquely septate. Note: the presence of leaf-like structures in gametophyte is the unique character of mosses, because in plant kingdom any gametophyte do not have leaf-like structure. They consist of upright slender axis bearing spirally arranged leaves. Vegetative reproduction in mosses is by fragmentation and budding in the secondary protonema. During sexual reproduction, sex organs are produced at the apex of leafy shoots. The sporophyte in mosses is more elaborated, is more developed than in liverworts. The sporophyte of moss is divided into foot, seta and capsule. The sporophyte of mosses is also partially depend like that of hornworts, which means it is photosynthetic. The moss have an elaborate mechanism of spore dispersal. Note: peristomial teeth are present in moss sporophyte, which helps in spores dispersal. In liverworts, elaters helps in spores dispersal. In hornworts, pseudoelaters helps in spore dispersal. In mosses, peristomial teeth helps in spore dispersal. Examples of mosses: Fynaria, rope moss, polytrichum, hairy cob moss, sphagnum, peat moss or bog moss. Once again I am repeating. Examples of mosses: Fynaria, rope moss, polytrichum, hair cap moss, sphagnum, peat moss. Let's check the diagrammatic representation of Fineria gametophyte and sporophyte, sphagnum gametophyte. Fineria is also called rope moss. Let's see gametophyte, which contains rhizoids, main axis, leaf-like structures. Sporophyte contains seta and capsule. Let's see sphagnum gametophyte, which contains archegonial branch, branches, antheridial branch. Let's check these diagrams carefully for your better understanding. Sphagnum is important moss, which is also called peat moss or bog moss. Peat moss or bog moss, it is a fossil fuel that obtained from bog. The formation of peat takes place by the fossilization of sphagnum. Sphagnum grows in acidic bog. The number of bacteria are less in bog, due to which the degradation of dead cells could not take place. Hence, it is present in the form of fossil. Absorbent cotton and sphagnum can absorb water in very high amount. Therefore, it is used in the form of absorbent cotton in Europe. Bryophytes in general are of little economic importance, but some mosses provide food for herbaceous mammals, birds, and other animals. Species of sphagnum, a moss, provide peat that have long been used as fuel, and because of their capacity to hold water as packing material for transshipment of living material. Mosses, along with lichens, are the first organisms to colonize rocks and hence are of great ecological importance. They decompose rocks, making the substrate suitable for the growth of higher plants. Since mosses form dense mats on the soil, they reduce the impact of falling rain and prevent soil erosion.